this tavis.
Ta'wil.
Tavis. And you keep this in your corner of your home. And inshallah, after 10 days, inshallah these tavis will benefit you. Or you will read Surah Baqarah for 10 days. Or I will come and read Surah Baqarah for 10 days. What will you say about this?
We tell this person, you read Quran on yourself. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, he will give you the shifa. Don't wear the ta'weedah or put the ta'weedah here and there.
Oh, when I asked about the ta'weez, he said there is nothing but the Quran ayat is there. So there is nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, even that. We just explained today, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is not allowing us to wear anything, even if it is from the Quran.
Not wearing, keeping in your home.
Even keeping, the same thing.
Thanks.
Okay, brothers and sisters, maybe Allah reward you. Tomorrow, inshallah, 9 o'clock. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, in the hadith of Abi Huraira, Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu was giving a task to protect the sadaqah. And the sadaqah happened to be pile of dates. So Abu Huraira every night would guard that pile of dates. And three consecutive nights, he caught a man stealing. The first night, he caught him. He said, please forgive me, excuse me. I am a poor fellow. I have children. And he released him. Okay? In the morning, he informed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, no, he will come back. He's a liar. He will come back. Abu Huraira said, I waited. Because the Prophet told me he's coming, I waited. I caught him. He said the same thing. I released him. The Prophet ﷺ said he will come back. The third night he caught him. He gave lame excuses. Abu Huraira said, no way. I will not let you go. He said, listen, Abu Huraira, I will teach you one thing. If you do it, the jinn will not come near to you. You'll be protected. So Abu Huraira said, okay, tell it. What is it? He said, when you go to sleep, read Ayatul Kursi. Read what? Ayatul Kursi. And Abu Huraira released him. In the morning, he informed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in this regard, Sadaqaka wa huwa kadhub. In this regard, he told you the truth, though he is a liar. But here, he told you the truth. What is the truth? Read Ayatul Kursi. Oh, Abu Huraira, do you know whom you have been talking to all this time? He said, no. He said, that is shaitan. So who taught Abu Huraira to read Ayatul Kursi? Who? Shaitan. And the Prophet ﷺ said, what he said is correct, but he is a liar. Which means, the nature of the jinn is what? Telling the truth or telling lies? Excellent. So the nature of the jinn, that they tell lies. So you cannot believe what the jinn say. Are you following, sisters? Okay, good. So here Allah says that they were men, and وَأَنَّهُ كَانَ رِجَالٌ مِنَ الْجِنِّ مِنَ الْإِنسِ يَعُوذُونَ بِرِجَالٍ مِنَ الْجِنِّ. So they were men, human beings, seeking help from the jinn, the shayateen. So the shayateen made the life of the men miserable. Because they start blackmail. They will blackmail you. We want this, we want that, we want this. Do this for us, the jinn. There is a sahir magician, a brother, Sheikh told me, who is an imam in a masjid in where I live. He said, and he's from Egypt, and he said, we ask one magician, sahir, who deals with the jinn. How do you call the jinn? When you want them, how do you call them? You know what he did? He took some ayat written on a piece of paper from his pocket. He said, whenever I want them to come, I take the ayat and I step over them. I put my foot on them. Then I call them, they come. That's how. So they come after you become a kafir. Or you throw the Quran in najasa, impurity. That's why the one who deals with the jinn, that he will come out of Islam. Are you following? So, and verily there were men among mankind who took shelter with the jinn. Male jinn, rijal min al jinn. Subhanallah, always men are troublemakers, even among the jinn. See, sisters, take care, That is the nature of men. With the male jinns, but they, the jinn, increased mankind in sin and disbelief. So the jinn, they made the life of human being miserable. Did you get a book, akhi? Did you get your own copy? Give them Kitab al-Tawheed. Page 58. In kufr, in disbelief, and sin. Imam Muslim, rahimahullah, are you following, brothers and sisters? Okay. Muslim reports that Khawla bint Hakim radiallahu anha said, I heard Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, and this hadith is sahih in Sahih Imam Muslim, man nazala manzilan faqala أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق لم يضره شيء حتى يرحل من منزله ذلك. The meaning, whoever goes into a dwelling and says while entering it, I seek refuge in Allah's perfect words from the evil of those creatures which He created, no harm shall befall him until he departs from that place. Memorize this dua. A'udhu bi kalimati Allah at-tammat min sharri ma khalaq. Wherever you go, a new house, you are traveling, anywhere, you say this dua. Okay? A'udhu bi kalimati Allah at-tammat min sharri ma khalaq. Okay. Now, so, alhamdulillah, Islam has taught us everything. How to protect ourselves from the jinn? Islam taught us. That is, you seek the protection of Allah. You say, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajeem, the shaitan will leave you. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you remove your clothes, you say, Bismillah. Then the jinn, they become blind, they don't see your awrah, they don't see it. You know what I mean? You are in the room. This is for the married couples. There is no awrah between a husband and wife. Husband and wife, they can remove their clothes and enjoy and fulfill their desires. If they don't say Bismillah, the jinns are watching, having fun. Okay? So, when you want to remove your clothes, you say Bismillah. They become blind. Finish. Is this clear? And you say, Allahumma jannibna shaytan wa jannib shaytan ma razaqtana. This is the dua you say. Oh Allah, save us from the shaytan and save our progeny